at Green Thumb Farm, the leading producer of cultured mushrooms, different species that they use as ingredients for delicious and healthy foods like shawarma, burgers, pizza, nachos, and even Filipino dishes like pork sisig, dinakdakan, and many, many more. This place has been developed by the owner, Miss Rona, and her husband, and this is a very accessible place. From the main entrance, the vast greeneries here towards the outdoor dining area is very accessible. Pwedeng-pwede natin ito, mga kaangat. This is wheelchair accessible. So, I would like to welcome you, Mrs. Rona Dinky, the CEO of Green Thumb Farm. Hello, Rona!
Hi, Mom! Good afternoon!
How are you?
Yes, welcome to our Green Thumb Farm al fresco restaurant.
Oh, thank
you. I'm happy that you have me in your program.
Okay. Tell me about your business. What made you pursue this type of business, mushroom production, when for me, it seems to be very complicated?
Okay. Ang business venture na ito ay nagsimula since 2017, since I am passionate in farming. So before the mushroom farming, nagsimula ako into various crops, no? And then someone introduced me regarding mushroom. Doon na nagsimula yung research ko regarding mushroom. On the first few years, talagang ano yan siya eh. Parang kailangan mo talagang i-sustain. Maraming mga bumps, maraming mga struggles. Pero ng Diyos, after 4 years of the struggles,
oh, yes,
after 4 years of all the problems na na-encounter namin dito, we came into the idea of opening this al fresco resto.
Yes. That's why it's not just an easy beginning. As what Rona said before, I have read in her post that you have to be a scientist, you have to be a chemist, everything.
Yes.
The passion of the birth of a mother.
Yes.
So it's not easy to start a business like this.
Kailangan mo talaga yung burning passion mo eh.
Yes,
kasi if you have that burning passion talaga, no matter what, kahit anong problemang ma-encounter mo, talagang masisurpass mo yun.
Yes, yes,
so,
yes.
Awa ng Diyos, I have that passion,
yes,
talaga in farm. Kasi sa mushroom, napaka-critical.
Yes.
All phases, apat na phases siya eh.
So,
sa phase 1 pa lang, may mga critical points na kailangan mo talagang tutukan.
Uh-oh.
No? Sa phase 1 hanggang phase 4, all phases,
uh-oh,
every critical points, ma-fail ka lang sa isa, wala na. Hindi mo na ma-sustain lahat yung four phases.
Okay. Good that you have sustained everything and now you have reached this level. So, are you affected by this pandemic?
Actually, it was a blessing in disguise na para bang naging blessing ang pandemic, no? During the first 2 weeks na nag-lockdown, yun yung punto na talagang iniisip ko, shall we continue? Pero I still continue to pray na Lord, give us the sign kung kailangan ko ba talagang stop or shall I continue? Kasi iniisip namin, we have farmers, yung mga employees namin, they also have families. So what if kung mag-stop ako, may mga pitong pamilya din na mawawala ng
panghanap buhay.
So sa awa naman ng Diyos, meron kaming nakuhang market niche sa Cebu in replacement doon sa market na nawala namin dito sa Bohol. So from that time, yung demand ni Rostans at saka ni Landers ng Cebu, naging higher pa siya doon sa existing demand namin.
Wow.
So it was a blessing.
Yeah.
So it was a blessing na talagang marami ng businesses na nag-close.
Yes.
Marami ng mga employees na nawalan.
And to think that during in the midst of the lingering effect of the pandemic, you still managed to open up the al fresco resto.
Yes.
Well, all others have already shut down, di ba?
Yes. Kasi naging ano din siya, kasi most of the people from the city are not strolling in city. The city or in the mall, so they prefer to hang out in this open
space. You have been recognized by mailing of your the uniqueness of your agri venture. Can you cite some of the awards and recognitions that you received for having this mushroom culture?
I am beyond blessed, no, from all the people, agencies who have been supporting us since day one. So we are very much lucky na like Department of Agriculture, APT, no, so API, Department of Trade and Industry, Department of Science and Technology, yung sa LGU natin, they've been supporting us. So siguro nakita nila na we are very much open to all those opportunities, no? Lahat ng mga trainings, lahat ng mga ino-offer nila na para ma-develop yung farm namin, ginagrab ko talaga. So, training after training. I have invested so much time in those training talaga. Kasi, on my part, hindi naman talaga ako agriculturist, no? So, it took so much time for me to study. I am not a scientist. I am not even an agriculturist. Ano lang talaga ako, I'm an accounting by profession. Yeah. So nandun lang talaga yung passion ko, no? Yeah. So then yung mga agencies na nag-o-offer lahat ng mga tulong nila, no? Para din ma-develop, kasi tingin nila kami, ako at saka yung husband ko, we are very much willing to embrace all those trainings that they've been offering to us.
Okay. During our visit, this is my second time here already. During our visit here in January, Rona mentioned to me that she is hiring PWD. Did you find any hardship in dealing in terms of your communication and interaction with PWD?
Yung na-hire ko dito na PWD, they've been here, I think that was 2018. So, nag-tour sila as a group dun sa, name ng school nila. Bohol Deaf Academy, headed by Ma'am Magdales, no? So, nakita ko na, may interaction ako sa kanila. So, nakita ko nila sa kanila kung paano mag-communicate. Although, I don't have that learning yung sa mga hand signals. That was my first impression, how to communicate with them. Pero, nung nag-start na, siguro si Hansel yung name niya, he is, I think, 20 plus in age. Intellectually, So, madali niyang makapture yung mga simple lang na mga
instructions,
no? Pero pag kung hindi na namin ma-express into actions, we put into writing. Pero so
drawing
far wala
lang.
Yes, writing lang talaga. So they understand English. So yung communication
so
namin,
can also read.
Yes, even yung mga senior citizen namin na mga staff dito, they don't find hardship on communicating with him. Kasi madali lang siyang paintindihin, eh. Yung mga basic lang mga hand signals, nakakaintindi na siya. So I don't find hardship.
How did he manage to apply here? Because I know that aside from him, there are many aspiring applicants to join your business. So what made you prompt him over the other aspiring applicants?
Okay. Siguro it's one of my advocacy to help PWD. Now, when I saw the children came here, I asked the administrator, can you give me one graduated from your school?
Okay.
I want to hire PWD. So it was my desire to help, no? Even dito sa mga hindi naman talaga sila mga professionals, no? Sa farm din meron akong senior citizens, no? I don't go for tawag din, makikita mo sa grades nila. Yes, hindi. Yung kung
if they are very much willing to work, okay, and then they are very much willing to learn, I can hire them.
Yeah, it's kumbaga yung the attitude.
Yes, yun yung pinaka number one na requirement ko. Sabi ko nga kay Mamagdales, ma'am, yung requirement ko yung talagang ano, hardworking. Yeah, yes. Porsigido. Yun yun.
Now that you have hired an experience hiring a PWD, are you still willing to hire more PWDs in case your business will grow someday?
Yes. I even told Ma'am Magdales, Ma'am, can you give me another one who is in charge in the kitchen?
Okay.
And then still, she's still looking for that one na pwede niyang maibigay sa akin.
Okay,
I am very
good
much
for you. Good
yes.
for you.
Yes.
we are looking really for more entrepreneurs like you who are willing to hire PWDs
yes.
in your company.
Yes.
You have a very beautiful place here, na natural landscape. And so aside from your outdoor dining, what more can you offer for others to appreciate the beauty of nature here?
Okay. Yung concept natin is farm to table, you know? So people can come here and enjoy our food, and while waiting for the food to be served, they can visit our farm, mushroom farm production.
Yeah.
So it's part of the tour na they can learn going inside the production area.
Yeah, okay.
And then someone who can lead them inside
yeah.
and then give them some input on what mushroom is, on how to grow mushroom. And then after ng tour ng production area, they can come here and enjoy our food.
Yeah, okay.
And enjoy our food.
And also I saw in your FB page that this place is also ideal for prenups.
Yes.
I saw this very, the beauty of the place is ideal for prenup
yes.
photo ops.
Yes. Actually, may nag-i-inquire na, yun, nakita, may nag-ano na, may nag-prenup na. May schedule na din kami for, mga ilang nagpa-schedule na rin for prenup. And then, inquiring us kung pwede ba makapag, garden wedding dito, no? So maraming mga opportunity na hindi talaga namin na in-expect na people would appreciate this and people would give us some idea na pwede pala siya dito.
Yes.
During that time, pwede pala ganun.
Yeah. Pwede na rin ito, mayroon na rin spaces for banquet.
Yes.
Diba?
Yes.
You have lot of space here that can accommodate wedding.
Yes.
Wedding event.
Yeah, some of the diners here are family. So, family who can bring their children. And then, since spacious yung area natin, so they can play around.
Yes,
the children can play around.
It's very safe.
Yeah. yes.
So, what do you see? What do you foresee Green Thumb Farm in the next 5 years? What still do you want to achieve?
Simula sa pool pa lang na nagsimula kami dito, we start very small but we always think big. No? Yun yung ano talaga na, starting small but aiming higher. No? So, nagsimula kami na 7 lang yung employees namin until now, naging 23 na sila.
Wow.
And then hopefully by in 5 years time, maybe marami na kaming
meron na kayong factory.
Siguro may mga extension na ng growing houses and then they can see some structures na para ma-cater din namin yung iba pang mga yes
from production to production to dining
and then yung hopefully kung naging okay na yung tourism natin we can cater more tourists to come in the farm
yes.
Yun yung preparation yun talaga natin
yun din ang natin yung farm tourism
yes hopefully
we
okay
are looking
na.
This place for farm tourism
thank you po
all for today Miss Rona. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to see you and hear your wonderful story about the growth of a Green Thumb Farm. I hope you will continue to explore and to be creative and innovative so that a more delectable and exciting food.
Yes.
So that will be all for today, mga kaangat. I hope you like our video, the episode for today. Please continue and keep watching our videos that we will be sharing about accessible places here in Bohol. Thank you and good day. Bye for now.